recital, I think of a performance in a concert setting.
Applied to my work, what it means is a way of bringing to life people's legacies through installations that focus on the lives of certain individuals who I believe have either been ignored or underappreciated. Defined the blues from a vocal standpoint, taking it from country and bringing it to a level of sophistication with orchestration, with instrumentation that was reflected in a lot of urban centers, all of whom had southern backgrounds. The layers of paint are equal to the number of records titles that she released for Columbia Records. She was the biggest seller that Columbia had. She came along at a time when the technology was able to pick up all the subtleties of the dynamics of her singing. So this idea of an artist having the mass audience, being able to reach them in very emotional ways, to me was a great feat. So that one image symbolizes all that for me. Matthew Henson was an Arctic explorer. He went on about 7 Arctic expeditions with Peary, discovered the North Pole. He was the first man at the North Pole, or what they then thought was the North Pole. Admiral Peary had frostbite and couldn't continue, so Matthew Henson was the first one there. I knew what was missing was an iconic sculptural embodiment of his experience in the art. I think it's important to recast other individuals who would not ordinarily have been considered artists, or their activities not even considered to be artistic activities. We could, as I have with Matthew Henson, look upon their activities as grand, even more purposeful, artistic activities of creative research.
Thank you.
grand, even more purposeful artistic activities of creative research. Jimi Hendrix, in many ways, saved my life, moving me from a crowd of wayward kids that I shouldn't even have been around. I heard the poetry of his music, and that was that. I wanted to put Jimi Hendrix and Martin Luther King together because not only did they come into my life at the same time, but they were both pacifists.
I'm using as a subject from which to preach why I am opposed to the war in Vietnam.
There's no greater pacifist plea to me than Martin Luther King's why I'm opposed to the war in Vietnam speech, and no greater pacifist rallying call than Jimi Hendrix's Machine Gun.
It is estimated that we spend $500,000 to kill each enemy soldier, while we spend only $53 for each person classified as poor.
To put the two of them together was a very natural thing.
Thank you. Chapter on discovering what it means to be an American. I, like many a writer before me upon the discovery that his props have all been knocked out from under him, suffered a species of breakdown and was carried off to the mountains of Switzerland. There, in that absolutely alabaster landscape, armed with two Bessie Smith records and a typewriter, I began to try to recreate the life that I had first known as a child and from which I had spent so many years in flight. It was Bessie Smith, through her tone and her cadence, who helped me to dig back to the way I myself must have spoken when I was a picnic, and to remember all the things I had heard and seen and felt. I had buried them very deep. I had never listened to Bessie Smith in America in the same way that for years I would not touch watermelon. But here in Europe, she helped to reconcile me to being a nigger.
Nigger.
Beethoven, there's not one portrait. There are portraits that exist to show him as a man who looks just like me. There are portraits that show him as the great white father of music. All I was trying to do was to present counter information to balance the historical ledger about what he might have looked like. Now, in my opinion, that's a small matter, whether he was black, white, or whatever. The greater matter is how this man overcame deafness to write some of the most powerful music that exists that's still fresh today. How his interior experience of being shut out and cheated as a composer by the one sense that distinguishes them from everybody else, robbed of theirs, how the human triumph of the story of overcoming that, which would have destroyed a lesser individual, rose from that experience and wrote some of his greatest music.
Enjoy the rest of the Performa. Thank you.
Terry Adkins.
I recently went home to see my mother, and I hadn't been there in years. That's a bad thing to say, but I really hadn't. I went back to visit her recently, and to her delight, I went to church with her on Sunday. And to her surprise, I remembered all the responses by heart, like a good little Catholic boy should. But one of the things that came across was that this early exposure to a space, an architectural space, that was meant for ceremony as well as contemplation, had a profound effect on me. And I think you can see the evidence of that throughout these spaces. The symmetry of it, the ceremony of it, the relationship of the orator to the audience. I don't know whether faith is the right word. I think it has to do with my belief that art can be a force for change.
Okay.
How you doing?